Good morning, students. Today we are going to see term 1 6th standard science lesson 2 forces and motion part 1. Okay students, before enter into session you should be take a notebook for writing important points. Let us start our second lesson, forces and motion. In this lesson we are going to learn identification of push and pull, or both is involved when there is a motion. Understand that some forces act on contact and non-contact forces. Third one, when a force is applied, it can make some changes. Fourth one, types of motion. Fifth one, deduce the definition of average speed and its units. Last, compute time, distance and speed. So, from above points, we will learn what is push, pull, force, motion, types of motion and how to calculate average speed, distance in our daily life. Okay, now we will see one by one. First one is what is push and what is pull. Push and pull are opposite forces, meaning they move objects in different directions. For example, see the below picture, a person pull and push the door. So the door goes front and back. In second picture shows game of tug of war. People pull the rope to opposite sides, so the direction changed. In third picture, one person push a heavy weight and another person pulls that. So, push is a force to move something away from oneself. Example, rolling a ball, stick a glue, throw a ball, kick the ball, put away a book, writing. Pull is a force to move something toward oneself. Example, pull the zip in shirt, tie the knot in shoe, climbing the rope, take a book from shelf, open the door, wearing socks. Next, what is motion? When there is a change of position of an object with respect to time is called motion. Example, running, boxing, skipping, weightlifting. From these activities, a person moves from his position. So, it is called motion. We learnt motion. Tell me, what is rest? As you all know, there is no change in object. Yes, your body is said to be at rest if does not change its position with respect to its surroundings. See the book in a table, there is no force applied, so no changing of its position. Bench in a park also in rest condition. So the above examples explained rest. From motion and rest, we get an idea that both are relative. Okay, shall we see some examples? The girls in the boat is moving with respect to the river. But the girls are rest with respect to the boat. The girl on the swing is rest with respect to the seat. But she is moving with respect to the garden. Girl on the bicycle is moving. But she is rest with respect to the cycle. So finally, an object is at rest in relation to a certain set of objects and moving in relation to another set of objects. This implies that rest and motion are relative. Now, you tell me the difference between rest and motion. Rest is if its position does not change with respect to a particular place. Example, book on the table, bench in a park. Motion is changing of position with respect to time. Example, a flying bird, boy playing football. Do you know the great Indian astronomer and mathematician of Aryabhatta said that the banks of the river appear to move back to a person in a boat floating gently in a river. The night sky studded with stars appear to move from east to west, while earth rotates from west to east. Okay, how things move? Because of force. Yes, forces are push or pull by an animate or inanimate agency. Example, in our daily life, pull down water from well, push or kick a ball, it moves. So a person using animate or inanimate agency to done a work is called force. So the forces are classified into two types. One is contact force, another one is non-contact force. Here the animate and inanimate factors induce force. What is contact force? The force is executed by touching the body is called contact force. What is non-contact force? The force is applied without touching the object. Shall we see some examples? A person kick a ball means person touches the ball. So it is a contact force. Magnet attract an iron nail without touching the object. So it is called non-contact force. Like that, ripe apple or any object fall to the ground due to gravity. So magnetism and gravity are some examples of non-contact force. Shall we see, discuss some examples of contact force? Kick a ball, person walking in the floor, person pulling the load. These examples shows person touches inanimate objects. So the force is contact force. Examples of non-contact forces. First one, mass of object and its distance determines the strength of its gravitational force. Newton's law expressed this gravity force. Second, materials such as iron, cobalt, nickel are attracted by magnet without touching. The third picture explains electrical force. Balloon do not conduct electricity, but you could rubbing with a sweater or cotton and taken into near of your head means charged balloon pulling uncharged hair or ball. Yes, if you are rubbing with the sweater now, it will get negative charge and attract the positive charge of hair. What happens when a force is applied? See the video clip, what happens when a batsman hit a ball? The ball already in motion because it was thrown by someone. If a person hit the ball with bat, the speed of the ball was increases. Here the application of force on object results change in its speed and direction. Next, apply a force on roti duff and see the results. Expansion or contraction takes place. It shows change of shape of the object. We can see effects of a force. Shall we discuss some examples? A man uses a force to move a stationary lawn owner. A football uses a force to change the direction of motion of a ball. A cyclist uses a bigger force to pedal his bicycle and increase its speed. A baker uses a force on his dough to shape it into a curry puff. So, force can change the states of body from rest to motion or motion to rest. It also changes the speed or direction or body, both of the body. Force can also change the shape of the body. This is simple activity. Tell me the answer. Force can move from rest, change the speed, stop the motion, change the shape, change in its direction, compress or expand. This is mind map. From this, we will learn what we are discussed earlier. Push can move an object away from you. Pull can move object towards you. Then motion is a change in position and force is a push and pull in a particular direction. So push and pull involved in force and motion. But rest is no change in its position with respect to the surrounding. Okay students, now the time to recollect our portion. Let us see some textbook pages. This is page number 18. Lesson 2 starts. Learning objectives given in that page itself. We discussed earlier. Introduction given in page number 19. Motion and rest explained in that page. Motion is change of position of an object with respect to time. No change in position is called rest. In 19th page, they are given first activity.
You have to find whether it is push or pull. Page number 20 given the conversation. Three characters are involved. Once you read and will get the idea for motion and rest. Next, page number 21 discuss some examples for moving and rest. At last, in page number 21, we concluded that rest and motion are relative. At last, in page number 21, from the examples, we concluded that rest and motion are relative. Page number 22, given activity 2. Think by yourself and tell the answer. And this page explains how the things move in our daily life. Either push or pull will be the reason for force. So, page number 22 given the definition of force. Forces are push or pull by an animate or inanimate agency. That page itself, they explained types of forces. Contact and non-contact forces. Force executed by touching the body is contact force. Force applied without touching the object is called non-contact force. Page number 23 given the examples for contact and non-contact forces. Page number 24 explains the effect of force. Yes, force can change states, direction, speed, position and shape. There is a simple activity also. Try by your own. Okay students, I hope you are all understand about push and pull, force and motion. Now the time for evaluation. Be ready students. First Roman letter is fill up the blanks. Number 1, gravitational force is a dash force. Number 2, kicking a ball is dash force. Number 3, a change in the position of an object with time is dash. Fourth one, dash are push or pull by an animate or inanimate agency. Fifth one, the girl on the swing is dash, rest or motion. Second Roman letter, answer the following questions. First question, define force. Second question, give one example for contact and non-contact force. Third one, write the difference between rest and motion. Fourth one, see the below picture and circle it, which is push or pull. Okay students, answer all these questions in your notebook. If you are having any doubt, note the question into the notebook and it will be clarified on reopening day. Download the textbook using the link provided in the description below this video. Lesson 2 is to be continued in next session. Thank you.